Well, hello, my dears. I have a little friend here, big friend here. She didn't want to get off the seat, so she's just gonna join us. This is Kira. She's a Rhodesian Ridgeback from Africa. Kind of fits what we're gonna talk about, actually. We're gonna talk about small space solutions. All right, I love this topic because... I'm gonna share with you some really genius ideas for how to deal with small spaces. And if you have a large space, just do exactly the opposite of what I'm saying. So first of all, let's just talk about like the shell of the room or the house. The shell, or they call it the envelope. We'll start with the floors. First of all, try not to use area rugs. So area rugs are used for zoning. They create this foundational area where different things are happening. They're really great for breaking up a large space, but in small spaces, try to skip area rugs. And in fact, try to skip different types of flooring. I would suggest using one type of flooring throughout the whole apartment or whatever we're talking about. Same concept goes for your walls. So instead of painting your doors a different color, your trim a different color, your walls a different color, ceilings, accent walls, try to make everything as big and as connected as possible. So pick one good color and paint your trim, your walls, your doors, everything is the same. So it feels as big as it can be. The next thing I would suggest is to have a really great focal piece. So that might be a really great chandelier. It could be a piece of art on the wall. I try to, if I'm in a small space, I try to have my focal point be somewhat flat, right? So a mirror that's laying on the floor, like up against the wall, that's really great. Mirrors are awesome too because they'll double the space. They'll create the illusion that there's way more light and space going on there. If you do have to use a piece of furniture, I'm going to talk about the furniture next. So if you are dealing with a small bedroom, for instance, I would say forget the king size bed. Just know going into this that you've got to try to make the queen size work, or twin. There's a whole bunch of things you can do with the bed to make it feel less invasive. There's Murphy beds, and there are DIY tutorials on how to make your own Murphy beds. There are futons and sofa beds, trundle beds, hide beds, those types of things. I would try to not use a headboard, actually. I think that headboards and footboards take up a lot of space, especially sleigh beds, right? So a theme that you are going to see throughout this talk today is that you are trying to analyze everything about your space and your items in that space and eliminate all unnecessary mass. You want as much airflow and light flow as you can get, okay? So, for instance, for a bed, if you need to put it up underneath a window, try to not cover hardly any of that window. And another way you could do this is use like a wrought iron bed. My bed is currently this way right now. It's wrought iron and it is up against a window, but you can still see the light coming through because of the style of the frame. So another look I love are platform beds. I love these ones from Urban Outfitters. Platform beds do not require a box spring. So again, you've got low to the ground, not taking up unnecessary space. Anytime you create more space up above, it's gonna feel better, right? So no headboard, no box spring, very small legs, and Urban Outfitters has these beautiful ones that are carved and just look so timeless and elegant. Same goes for nightstands. So try to think, how can I not have legs on the nightstands, or how can I have it low? I mean, you want to be able to use your nightstand when you're laying down but not have any extra height if you don't have to. You can do a shelf coming off the wall as your nightstand. You could do a hanging nightstand. You could do nesting tables. So if you're like maybe eating a meal in your bed or something, you could pull them all out. Otherwise, they all condense. Lighting is the same. So if I'm trying to decorate a small space, I do not even think about using table lamps. Everything is hanging or a sconce on the wall. And try not to take up your floor space, because that real estate is at a premium. So no lampshades. If you can get away with that, use Edison bulbs, or you use clear glass for the lampshades. That helps. Remember, we're wanting light and air to flow. Okay, storage is always an issue with small spaces. I understand that. Anything that you can pull out and use and then put back is gonna be a win, okay? So these three-tiered carts from IKEA on wheels are wonderful. You can just push them back in a corner when you're done, or slide them into a closet. Open shelving, I know, is super trendy, but I feel like it is really risky in a small space, because you need to store things somewhere. And so if you like load up those shelves with books and DVDs and, you know, knickknack type things, it's going to look very bad, very fast, very, very cluttered. So if you must do open shelves, again, you will have the light and the air flowing, but be very strategic with your storage pieces and have them all very uniform, all in a row, you know, to hide the different colors and things going on there that are not decorative. So wire baskets can be good for this, because again, air and light flowing. Furniture wise, you want to have desks that don't have drawers. You want to have desks that maybe are those, like I did a bar desk in my son's room, because his room is really small. So it's like basically a large shelf coming off the wall. Those are good. So chairs that have desks, you know, like old school, where the desk part is part of the chair and then maybe it folds down, that can be good. Corner desks can be good. You can put a desk in an armoire, and I don't see this as much, but they still make those, you know, office armoires that open up and you slide in. My desk is currently in a closet and it's working fine. It's super cute. I'll show you the video on that. Okay, and then as far as tables, anything with glass tops, skinny coffee tables with just like, you know, skinny metal legs, nothing big and curvy, nothing with no extra mass on your furniture. Acrylic chairs, those can look really cool and really subtle in a vintage room. And then as far as chairs, try not to do arms if you can. So Parson chairs are really good. Slipper chair, they're called slipper chairs. Those are good for, you know, living room, bigger accent chairs. So couches, none of this big puffy cushion stuff going on with the couches. You want everything real tight, streamlined, real skinny arms, low arms. Sectionals are good. Rather than having a couch and a sofa, just put them together. You're saving a little bit of space there. Tables that are round, you know, you lose that the corners. So all this stuff adds up. And then just rethinking your spaces for how they're being used. So one example I like to use is, we had a really small house at our last place. And so my kitchen was my homeschool room with my three kids for many years. And I had to transform this room each day and then take it all back down. So what I ended up doing was, my pantry became the actual school room. All the school supplies were in there. From ceiling to floor, I had all these bins and like plastic drawers that we could pull out, and board games or whatever we were using. All of it was really packed tight into that pantry, and my Costco food supplies and stuff were kept out in the garage. And then also think about using the insides of your doors, just things that you don't normally see as having potential. So I would open that pantry door, and on the pantry door would be like all the letters, you know, for the kids were little then, but like their ABCs and like maybe a map and the solar system and that kind of stuff was all right there, like a wall that opened up and then it would close away. So another thing I like to do is, if I'm needing extra storage, I will hang one of those like fabric shoe organizers that has all the little pockets for your shoes. I will maybe put like bathroom storage in it or something. So think about those kinds of spaces and how you can reuse, like storing under beds, storing it up in closet areas, and just really analyze your space and maximize everything. I even saw a kitchen table, which I thought was so cute. It was a little two-seater kitchen table and it folded up like a Murphy bed, and it had shelves and you could put like your spice jars on it, and then when you want to eat, you have to take everything off, but then it folds down and you can eat there. So any type of space that you can convert in and out throughout the different needs during the day is gonna be really smart. And I love studying RV makeovers for this reason. Oh my word, the trend the last few years has just been phenomenal. Women, and I have several friends that have done this, taken RVs and completely made them over to look, you know, farmhouse or glam or shabby chic or something, and just done such a beautiful job. And if you study what they've done, you can get more inspiration for your space. So, for instance, Cami from Tidbits redid hers, and you'll see some of the things I've talked about she does in her RV. So all of her dishes are white, and she has like one beautiful oil painting and a little chandelier, and then everything else is really subdued. She has, the kids have bunk beds, so instead of two bunk beds, she squeezed in three bunk beds. So study RV makeovers for inspiration. Study tiny houses. I've seen whole nurseries done in a closet, super cute. Or bedrooms, like instead of doing an actual bedroom, it's just a loft, and instead of having stairs that go up into the loft, they have a spiral staircase or something, because those take up less room. I even saw one where the parents slept upstairs and they had a toddler, but instead of instead of a toddler bed mattress up there with them, they had a nice huge dog bed. Which probably sounds bad to some people, but hey, it worked for the time being. And so just think outside of the box with exactly what it is that you need and what it is that you don't need. There are whole decorating companies that are now catering to small space living. So CB2 is one that you could check out. They specifically cater towards small spaces. West Elm has a whole furniture line that is called Small Space Furniture. So you could check that out too. So hopefully you got some inspiration there. I actually really like working with small spaces. I mean, I like working in big spaces too, but I love the challenge of it, and just knowing some of these tricks and bringing in all these different multi-purpose type items and bringing in glass and things on wheels. And it's just fun to make it all work when you feel like, oh, how could it ever work? So one of the things you're gonna wanna do in a small space is constantly declutter. I'm gonna link my decluttering flow chart for you in the description below, and you can print that out and just have it beside you as you're trying to declutter. Especially people like to declutter in the fall too, I find. But anyway, that's available for you. And just wanna say thank you so much for watching. And if you're new here, please consider hitting that subscribe button. I do post regularly, and I share my professional design advice for the DIY home life. All right, take care. I will talk to you soon.